Okay, so wait. So, like, there's so much to discuss. First of all, opening night, Dolly's there, of course. Dolly Parton's there.
And
Jane Fonda and Lilli Tomlin and Dabney Coleman. All the original cast of 9 to 5, the movie, all sitting together. Yeah. Like,
no, it was
just legends.
Mind-blowing legends. To see everybody together.
So weird. Yeah. And then to see them, like, just to know that, like, we were there watching when they saw the show.
And they're
sitting
there watching, and they're all sitting. Every time they walked in, everybody got a standing ovation.
Yeah. The show starts, and there's Allison Janney and Megan Hilty and Stephanie J. Block portraying these women with these women watching. And we had, like, the perfect seats to be, like, in between them. Like, it felt like you could, like, feel the energy of, like, those ladies watching those ladies. Like, Stephanie J. Block had to have been freaking out.
Had to be.
Because, like...
No, had to be. Well,
like,
I think
Jane
Fonda.
Like, they all,
must have,
like,
had
they
to
all
be.
Must have been. Like, Allison Janney, I feel like she, like, can, like...
Oh. She's probably friends with them.
Yeah, she totally
I would
is.
Assume that Allison's definitely, like, hangs out with them.
I feel like when she's on stage, I feel like I'm in the presence of, like, just greatness. Like, she's just so... poised. Like, it's just so cool that she's doing the show because Allison Janney is so amazing at everything she does. She could step on Broadway and win a Tony easily doing Chekhov. But she chooses to do what's really hard for her, which is musical theater. And she's so natural at it. She's like Carol Burnett up there.
She's so good.
She's so good and she's so
poignant.
She can
do anything.
So funny.
That's what I love, the fact that she was doing that. I was like, wait, I love that this actress who could do Oscar-winning movies and has done Oscar-winning movies is totally going to Broadway and supporting Broadway and doing Broadway.
And being like, wait, that's cool. Like, like that's what's hard and cool. And she does, like, a big production number.
Oh, a great production. That's my favorite number. She has
this
big production number. It's my favorite number.
And she has amazing scenes with Andy Carl or
Faith
Husband, who we love.
We wanted him to be naked, but he wasn't.
When he came out on stage the first time, I was sitting there so I said, take off your clothes.
Deliver me a package.
It's okay.
Deliver me a package.
Orfe knows I'm obsessed. Even Andy at the party last night when I went up to hug him, I think I saw an eyes be like, oh God, here he comes. Megan Hilty is a star.
She's a star.
She's like infusing Dolly. Like it's like, it's Dolly, but it's Megan. And like anybody who saw Megan do Glinda in Wicked, which was, she's like kind of my favorite Glinda. She was amazing.
That's what I heard.
And it's so
she's a star.
Fun.
I watched
like,
that and I said, oh, she is a star.
My one
she's
note, my one big note for the show, and they have lots of time till April when
I have
they
no
open
notes.
In New York. Be careful, you don't have pants on.
I don't have pants on.
My one note, and it's not, Megan's first big number is Backwoods Barbie.
See, while he's giving notes, I'll show my tushy.
This is going to be so good for my show. I hope.
And then
one
it makes
note.
Up. Okay, give your note, but I'm not
which
in frame.
Which is Backwoods Barbie. Megan stands and sings Backwoods Barbie, like center stage, and it's a gorgeous song, but I feel like it should be a huge production number as opposed to just a stand and sing number.
I do agree with the fact
Joe
that
Mantello,
I want it to be a
I love you.
Number.
I think you're a genius, and you know that I think you're a genius. No, you don't. We've never met.
Wait, I want to do the number Backwoods Barbie.
You know
because
what?
Because in
I
reality,
have to
say,
I
have to
it's
say
backwards,
I...
though, not backwards.
Oh, well, I want to do this song, Backwoods. Wait, is it really? I thought it was Backwoods Barbie.
No, Backwoods.
But I was thinking... That makes a lot more sense.
I was thinking last night, you could play that role. I really think you could
play
that role.
See, that's why people have best friends.
Do you think I could play Stephanie J. Block's role?
Now I'll just say yes, because you just said I could do Dolly Parton.
Halfway through the first half. Halfway through the first act, the set broke down, so Dolly got up and sang 9 to 5 in the audience.
And here's what I'm going to say is that I had heard that happened during
preview.
The first preview. So right when it started happening, I looked to Ryan and I said,
planned.
Oh, this is such a plan. We're all going to get to see her sing, which was so exciting, but I'm like, planned.
But it wasn't.
So wasn't.
It took
so
long.
It was.
There's
it
no was, way they would have planned it because it took them like when Dolly like wasn't singing, it was like okay.
It was like
what?
It was
like,
literally.
She stopped singing,
I texted,
and then she had to give a speech to like fill time.
Yeah, and then
like it was like.
And we
really,
had friends
like,
that were sitting on the other side of the audience, and they heard
drilling.
Yeah. So
it was like a serious.
Yeah. So it
like,
actually was a real malfunction.
And I guess.
It,
9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. What about our new best friends? John Lloyd Young and Leah Michele.
We have new best friends.
But you can hear Leah laughing on that, actually. Leah Michele and John Lloyd Young were sitting right behind us.
Right. And if you don't know who they are, name.
Lea Michele was in
Spring Awakening. And was amazing. And totally outed me.
I totally did.
I was like, oh, yeah, I totally like Spring Awakening. And he's like...
And I was like, oh, no, Lea, you need to understand. The only CD in her car. It's the only...
Okay. Anyways, back to
and
Dolly.
John Lloyd Young was there, too, who won the Tony for Jersey Boys. He played Frankie Valli.
And I think they're dating.
Maybe not. That's why I said
it. I don't think it's a secret. But if it is a secret, I'm really sorry.
I don't think it's a secret,
It
right?
can't be a secret.
It wasn't... They weren't making any secret about it last night. Cute and fun. And now they live out here, so I think they're going to be our new theater friend.
I think my baby's crying.
I'm
back. It wasn't my baby. It was our friend Bruce Glikas, who's in the kitchen, and he wanted us to not out people. He's supposed to be watching the baby.
Do people not know that they're dating?
Allegedly.
I think they're.
Come say hi, Bruce.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bruce Glikas, who's supposed to be watching my baby.
You know, I'm a bad babysitter.
Hey.
No outing people.
I didn't know. Honestly, I thought they were. Didn't they do the press line together?
Ryan Hilton. Whatever.
For those who don't know, Bruce Glikas is the Broadway.com photographer.
Whatever. Anyway, I'm doing what I can for the Broadway community at large.
Okay.
Very large.
I just have to say, my baby is sleeping like this in the crib.
He's gorgeous.
And now we can hear him if he cries. Okay, go do your laundry. Take the monitor. We don't.
And the whole. Oh, this is what I really wanted to talk about. The choreography.
Of 9 to 5.
The choreography, Andy Blankenbuehler. Amazing. Yeah. His choreography is so cool. He did In the Heights, too. And he's
so cool.
He has the most amazing way of like going from really cool, like staccato, cool, like almost Fosse-esque movement into like pedestrian walking.
Yeah.
That's so cool. And he weaves it into the show.
And like, really cool and really innovative.
Cool. Yeah, that's really cool.
That was really awkward for me. But it was very... I was going to congratulate you after the show. Oh, you were? I was just excited right then. But I just have to say, as a woman watching theater, to see three women leads, all so good, all so strong, was so exciting as an actress just to see that. Because it's very rare... I'm talking louder because there's a plane going overhead. But it's very rare to get to see... women doing strong women roles, and I think that that's why the movie 9 to 5 came about. They were talking about that at the premiere.
Yeah, that's what it was. Like, that's how it was, like, for that.
Jane Fonda went.
It was revolutionary in 1979 when they did the movie, and now it's revolutionary now for the theater.
Yeah.
And it was so cool, like, the three of them bowed together at the end, which I thought was so cute, which is like.
They're all stars. Like, there's not a moment where you're like, oh, that one's a bigger star. That one's, I mean.
Yeah, like I feel Megan like Allison is like is a break, the breakthrough star. Allison is
I feel like she's the rock of the show.
She's
I feel
the
like
rock.
Allison
yeah.
is totally the rock of the show. I feel like she's
and
like.
Stephanie J. Block, like that song totally that she shot. Has in the second act.
You think she's gonna.
Like, it's like, it's so alphabet.
That you think literally.
That I turned to her and I was like, because it's so good. Like, it comes from a place of like, it's so good and it builds and builds and she's singing her face off. And I turn to her and I go, is she gonna fly?
Yeah, there is a moment that you think, you're like Stephanie's about to fly and her face is gonna go green and she's gonna go.
And Lea and John were behind me laughing because they were. Going like
and they were thinking the same thing, that they were gonna fly. Ryan said when we first sat down to start shooting this, he said, if we ever really had our own show together.
Which is a great idea.
Which is a fabulous idea. I just want to put it out there in the universe. I'm going to secret it. I'm going to put a picture of us together.
Oh, that's a really good idea.
Ryan and I sat down. We both got into our positions, like how we thought we looked cute and better. Oh, I want to sit here. Oh, panties.
And like, I go like up.
And I go down to be like, hello, boys. We were discussing how when we have our show, because you have to say not if we have our show, when we have our show together and we're co-hosts of a really, really funny show, that we would actually have a hard time filming with real cameras. Because
we
both
don't
like,
both have different demands.
Like,
I think we'd both like Rosie's up camera.
Oh, my God. I'd love to be like, this the whole show?
So smart.
She's a genius.
She really is.
We love you, Rosie.
Love you, Rosie. It's always a good way to end. I love you, Rosie.
You know what? We should end. You should end every blog with
"I love you,
I love
Rosie."
You, Rosie. Vote for Obama.